All right. So good day, everyone. This is Ms. Torres. And for today, we are going to continue our lesson on queer theory, the Yogyakarta principles. And then today, we are going to discuss about gender and socialization. This is already lesson 5, no? For the discussion for this week. So lesson 5 under unit 3, gender systems, theories, and rights. So under unit 3, this is our 5th lesson under unit 3, gender systems, theories, and rights. And under unit 3, we are, or rather on under lesson 5, we are going to discuss about gender and socialization. Socialization refers to how people socialize with their greater social group, now whether that is the family, the school, their school, their community, their church, no? So that is socialization. So today we will discuss about gender roles and socialization, and then gender in government and law. In relation to gender in government and law, let me just share my screen, class, no? So yes, again, the lesson is gender and socialization, gender roles and socialization, and then gender in government and law. For the second part, we will discuss about women in government, particularly women in leadership roles in politics, and then also some laws that relate to achieving gender equality in the Philippines. So I hope my screen is showing. Let me just check it first in Google Chrome or Google Meet. Okay, I think that it's showing in Google Meet. So let's start. So for this lesson, we aim for students to be able to discuss the impact of the influence of socialization on gender roles. So particularly, what's the impact of your social group and how you aim to conform to gender norms? Now, for example, let's say, what's the impact of your family? What's the impact of your friends, of peer pressure, of social media, the impact of your community or of your religion on how you act as a girl or a boy? So maybe if you think about being a guy now, or being a girl, does your social group have an influence on your behavior as a young man or as a young woman? Definitely, yes. So we are going to look at how socialization impacts the behavior of people. Second, we will compare and contrast gender roles and differences between males and females. We will look at the differences of masculinity and femininity between boys and girls. Third, describe how society socializes individuals to accept gender norms. So how does society exactly influence people's behaviors in terms of their gender? We will learn about that. And then for the second part, for gender in government and law, you should be able to describe the status of women in government in the Philippines today and discuss the laws of society and in gender equality in the workplace. So I have some photos here, class, of some examples I apologize for some of the photo of the woman because I actually wanted to give an example of how women today usually post photos online in order to maybe show their beauty during a certain time. So that's just the purpose of this particular photo, the first one that we see here. But in any case, class, I think it's good for us to start off with looking at behaviors that are acceptable or unacceptable in society. So a case in point would be the first photo. So our thought process will be the behavior of a person, and then whether or not that is acceptable in society. And if that behavior is acceptable or not acceptable, will society prejudice them or ostracize them or accept them if they do that behavior? So the first example that we have here is of a girl nor of a woman. So typically nowadays we can notice that in social media or rather in general in Filipino society, girls now are expected to be beautiful now. So because of that expectation of beauty, girls have to conform to that norm of being beautiful. And if they do not conform to that norm of being beautiful, if, for example, they are in the plus size side of the body, of body sizes, not, what if a girl is plus size, or what if they have dark skin, what if they have curly hair, what if they're short, not, or what if they're extremely tall? Because I think in Filipino society, if a girl is very tall in our culture, it's not very good, no, and it's actually a source of insecurity for tall girls. And it's the same as well for petite girls, no. So if a girl doesn't conform to the standards of beauty, even in the form of a girl's cup size, for example, or weight, no, or skin, if they are not like the usual standard of beauty, then they will not be able to get, for example, in terms of having a relationship plus. I think because especially for young girls, no, the reason why they actually work hard to be beautiful is in order to attract a boyfriend, for example. So what if they aren't exactly that pretty? Are they able to get to still be accepted by their social group, no? And I think that's even the reason why girls post pictures on Instagram, no? And even beauty queens, from beauty queens to celebrities, they always post pictures of how pretty they are. Because do you think that it's their way of being accepted by society? Yes, no? Because in a way, that is indeed a form of wanting to be accepted or not in society. So if you decide to, should I post a picture today? I want people to, it's either a form of self-expression or it could be a form of really just wanting to be accepted now by one's social group. So that's the first example. The second, I'm really sorry for the second example again, but I want to be more sensitive in relation to this, because actually the reason why I put this example in the lecture is because recently I saw a friend of mine who posted on social media that they were serving in the church, no, but the friend of mine was actually gay. So I think to a degree, many people would actually have a slight comment about gay people serving in the church because they believe that being gay, that gay individuals should not be serving in the church because being homosexual is a sin in Christianity, for example. So the second example that I have here would be that gays are not supposed to serve in the church because they are sinners. So that's the behavior class now. It is a gay person in church acceptable or not? I think to a degree it is not acceptable for some Christian denominations, na, and even in Islam, I believe as well, din siya acceptable to serve in one's religion if they are homosexual. So since that is unacceptable, would a gay person who does go to church and who does serve get ostracized or get prejudiced because they are serving the church? So that's the first question. So yes, now the third example that we have is boys and men are not supposed to show that they are caring, that they love like a girl, that they are sensitive. So in terms of sensitivity for men, no, we will see that, or we can see that overall, we can notice that in our society, again, it's rather unacceptable for men to show emotion, as what we can see in the photo. I just put a photo of Johnny Depp there. because if they do show sensitivity or if they do show a feminine side to them, they might be labeled as gay, no? So in this example, similar to the previous example that I just gave, there is a level of unacceptability. So in society, it is unacceptable for a man to be sensitive. And because of that, if a man is sensitive, then they are rejected, or to a degree, parang there's a sense of rejection that other people would do towards them if they show a side that is feminine or sensitive. And with those examples, class, we look at the fact that I'm not going to label this as social experimentation. Let's just label it as socialization, gender socialization, gender and socialization. Yes. So with that, in relation to gender and socialization, let me just adjust this. So the boys and girls are expected to behave in a way that is acceptable in society, and those who do not agree to gender fixed patterns are prejudiced and ostracized by members of certain groups. Now, we can say that some theorists, no, I guess, referring to the book, kindly go to page 83, by the way, of the book. This is where we're going to, this is the lesson that we're basing this lesson on. So social theorists would say that gender is interactional rather than individual. So this means that our behaviors, no, are actually influenced by the interactions that we have with the groups around us, with our family, with our classmates, or with your classmates, with your teachers, with your school, with your church, no, or your the people in your religion. So our gender behaviors are influenced by our interactions rather than inherently that is who we really are. Even in social media, no, the way that we express ourselves in a masculine or feminine way is influenced by our interactions with our friends online. So it's not exactly masculinity or femininity is not exactly inherent in a person according to social theorists. On the other hand, gender is actually interactional rather than inherent in an individual, because we adjust our behaviors according to the social groups we are around with. And with that, in this lesson, we will look at facets associated with gender roles and socialization in the level of the family, school, labor, government, and even in language. So let's go to gender roles and socialization. So for gender roles and socialization, sometimes, let's start off with the family now. So sometimes children, as what we can see here in the book in page 84, so the family is the primary social unit of human life. Gender roles are taught from infancy through primary socialization. Parents would always give the notion that blue is for boys while pink is for girls. The family sets a social norm that the father is the head and breadwinner, and the wife takes care of household chores of the family. However, sometimes children oppose gender norms by behaving in ways contrary to their gender. Now, let's just jump to the part on adolescence. Now, so adolescence is the time, and I think most of you class are not even adolescents anymore. You are already teenagers or young adults, now, being 18 to 21. So in that sense, you are not exactly adolescents anymore. You are already young adults. And however, I guess it's still the same, now. In our culture, manggod, no, sa Philippines, in the Philippines, you are still actually in the age wherein you're still discovering your own identity. So in terms of knowing who you are, no, adolescence is the time when young people start to explore their gender identity and their sexuality as well. And starting off with identity development, so using the same examples that we had earlier, so let's look at how people, let's try to figure out, class, now, why do people conform to gender norms in their society? Why would girls go to great lengths in order to look beautiful, no? In order to just conform to the standard of beauty in society? Why would the LGBT have to fight, no, in order to be accepted in their church, for example, if they are Catholic, gay people? Why would they suffer rejection by their religion because of their faith? Because for them, who they are is really rooted in their religion. So why would they undergo rejection by society in order to keep their faith, no? Or for men who are sensitive, just like the example that I gave, should a boy conform to society and try to look more macho and try to act more macho in order to be accepted by their friends or by other people? Or should they show their feminine side, no, and risk rejection? So all of these are based on identity development. So because essentially the process is that when it comes to conforming to the norms of society, it really starts with a person's identity that, firstly, although this is something that we don't exactly think about nor are not aware of, we are unconscious of this, because often when it comes to conforming to our society, it is unconscious. Sometimes we just do conform directly without even thinking about what's happening. No? You just participate in social media without thinking about why you actually do it. That you don't realize it, but it's already a part of how you are developing your own sense of self. No? That your sense of self is actually being formed as you interact with or as you express yourself in social media through your pictures or through what you write. Or your sense of identity is based on, for example, your religion. No? So your identity as a Christian is very much based on whether or not you go to church, no? And whether or not it's okay for you to go to church, especially if you are homosexual, no? And then lastly, for men, no? A boy's identity, sometimes a man just conforms to his friends, to his family, without even thinking about whether or not they should they even conform to what their society is telling them. Sometimes they just do it, no? Like, for example, I saw a film class, no, I think that was last year, called Grease. And I think I've also given this example in my previous lectures. But in the film Grease, just to make the long story short, of course, the film stars John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John back in the 70s or 80s. And a key theme that I saw in that movie was the fact that John Travolta really conformed to his friends. He didn't want to seem like he was a type of guy who, excuse me, he was a type of guy who, what's the term there, who was sensitive, because he actually is a sensitive guy to a degree, but he always wanted to show this facade of being a tough guy, you know, because his friends are mga bugoy, magutoy ang mga friends. So muna nga, that's essentially the reason why he always wanted to show that he was a tough guy, you know, even though deep inside he is a sensitive guy. So in one scene, he actually pretended that he didn't know the character of Olivia Newton-John. More bitaw iyang gisnaban ang babae katong si Olivia Newton-John, gisnaban niya kay naa iyang mga amigo. So muna bitaw siya, that's a way of a man to want to conform to his friends. So more bitaw dili na siya conscious sa lalaki nga iya na gabuhaton nga kung ka-conform siya sa iyang mga amigo, pero muna na ang gabuhaton niya. And maybe the reason why he wants to conform to or wants to be accepted by his friends is because deep down inside he wants to keep that identity of being a tough person, even though in essence his identity is also sensitive. So more bitaw siya nag-clash ang iyang pagka-sensitive o iyang kagustuhan nga nga kanang na magmukha siya og tough nga person. So that these are aspects of a persona that is unconscious. Dili makita ka ng kabalo nga ah, so kuan din siya, based din siya sa akong pagkatao. Kay, I mean, if you translate the word identity, it really translates to pagkatao nimo. So imong pagkatao kay sensitive ka, tough ka, so pero dili kita, we are not exactly conscious of this, no? But this is according to sociology, and yes, the process is that your identity aids you, or rather somehow a person wants, there a person has a need to belong to, need to belong, no? Need to be, a person essentially has an inherent need to be accepted by others. So because a person wants to belong, no, so that is why they conform to gender norms in their society. And that is why a girl would go to great lengths in order to look beautiful, because she wants to belong to she wants to be accepted by society. That's the reason why. And even I think it goes the other way around. So whether or not they want to belong to their society or not, no, dili tanan tao po gusto ma-accepted sa society, dili tanan tao nga gusto mo please sa lain tao, no. So for example, if an individual is very much a self-assured, if they have their own self-esteem, ang ilang self-esteem kinaka-base ilang kagulingon, dili na sila kailangan og kanang, they do not need the affirmation of other people, then they will not go to great lengths in order to be accepted by others. They will not have that strong sense to belong to other people, because in themselves they are assured of their identity. So that it can also go the other way around, now that you do not need to feel like you belong not to other groups, and you do not need to conform to gender norms, because your identity is very important to you, and you would rather keep your identity than conform to society, you know? So just like in the example of the LGBT, for example, that for some LGBT who are religious, for example, because their relationship with God is more important to them than what other people say about them, you know? So they would still go to church, you know? Because it is important for them to keep their faith, no? And despite what other people would tell them about their sexuality, na dili sila dapat magtusimba, sila dapat mangalawat baka itong gay sila, pero they don't care, because they are assured of their identity, and dili sila mag-care unsa ingon sa lain. And I think I already gave as an example what I discussed now about men and sensitivity. So it will depend on the boy, I guess. Kay kuan man gud siya, I think lisod kina sa mga lalaki nang magkuan, no, kana bitong keep nila ang ilang sense of self. Kay typically man gud among men, masculinity is very important. Kay importante kay sila hang ma-accepted sila sa ilang mga peers, no, sila mga barkada. Usa mag they would go to great lengths, even though if their actions are already toxic, no, nga makasakit na sila sa lain, basta lang nga madawat sila sa ilang amigo, sa ilang mga amigo. So it would be good for men to challenge that about themselves, no, kay kuan man sad siya. There is a saying that your true friends will accept you for who you are. Pero kabulo ko nga sa mga lalaki, kay wala man ang true friends, di na sila mag-care kung true ba ang friends or dili, basta madawat na sila sa mga amigo. Muna, importante sila, ha? Pero, to a degree, nagaka-challenge na gamay ang imuhang kuan lugar. Kanang, for example, sige ka conform sa imong mga barkada, what if dili na gid maayo ang ilang gabuhaton, sabay ra gyapon ka kay tungod kay gusto ka nga madawat ka sa uban tao, mo na bitaw dili na sad na siya maayo, no? So or rather when it comes to showing sensitivity, for example, what if kaning kuan gid ka, you are really hurt during a certain period of time, or nakaigaagion niya, kanang gusto ka muhilak, or dili ka muhilak, kay tungod kay dili lagi dapat muhilak ang lalaki. So, kana siya kanang medyo, kuan na sad na siya, lopsided na siya, understanding sa emotional ni mga health, no? So, in that sense, it's just like what, I think this is a usual example, or this is a usual reference already, no? Just like what Pope Francis said in the past, no, in some of his past speeches, he said that it's actually therapeutic to cry, no, dapat muhilak more ang mga tao nowadays, kay dili lang ikupratanan, no. So that's just a discussion on showing emotions, especially for men. And in that sense, no, it's okay to be sensitive, and I guess other people should also understand others as well. Nga dapat dili na to i-label ang mga lalaki nga sensitive as gay agad. Pero napoy gamay pagka-annoying mong good class, no, kung sobraan na sad kaayo ka sensitive ang lalaki niya, wala dili tay level of masculinity na napoy gamay nga murag annoying sa tiyaga gamay sad. Pero sige lang, these are just some discussions anyway. Now let's look at approaches to understanding identity development. How do you actually develop that sense of identity in yourself, no? So accordingly to our book that is found in page 85, there are three approaches to understanding identity development. The first is your sense of identity. So you have to answer for yourself, no, who are you and what do you want to be? Are you a person who is, just like in this photo, no, for the girl, if you are trying to decide if you are going to post pictures of yourself, for girls, for example, post pictures of yourself on social media or not, you might want to, although kuan man kani siya, deep naman ni siya ng mga things, plus delete naman ni siya kuan yud ka ng, di manigaw na unaon sa mga tao kasagala. But I think it's healthy man to have that exercise of reflection every once in a while, to, especially if you're still a young person, na dapat imo gyud na siya answering a questions na, who am I? And unsa may akong gusto ma-achieve, ani akong gabuhaton sa social media nga ipang-post ako mga pictures, so kung gusto may tabo di ay. So, maybe as a young woman or as a girl, no, you might answer that question by saying that I am a girl that is, let's say, for example, if unconventional gigi ka mga babae, let's think of a character now that is, I guess it's maybe we can think of a girl character nga dili siya usual nga standard of beauty, pero kanang gina-consider siya as beautiful. So if you can think of anyone right now, that would be good class. But right now, top of my head example is America Ferreira. If you're familiar with America Ferreira, she is one of the actresses in Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants. So we have America Ferreira and then Alexis Bledel, Blake Lively, and then the girl who played I forgot her name, but that fourth girl in Sister to the Traveling Pants. And America Ferreira played Ugly Betty as well back in 2005, I think. And essentially, I really like America Ferreira class kay she's a Latina, no? She is, I'm not sure if she's plus size, sakto man yung lawas technically, pero Latina siya, but pero I think she can be considered to be plus size, no? Kay dili gid siya kanang standard sa beauty nga niwang. Kuan gid siya kanang plus size, siya gamay chubby, siya gamay, and yeah, she has dark hair. Her, I think now she has already matured because she's already in her 30s, I think, nowadays. Pero when she was a teenager, she was actually, yeah, plus size and had dark skin. Dili, she wasn't even that tall of a girl, no? Her features weren't exactly what you would call ano class the standard beauty lugar, pero eventually niniwang naman din siya pagdako niya or pagdako when she became older, no, or when she matured, she did become maybe I can just take show a photo just to illustrate. So this is America Ferreira with Reese Witherspoon. Yeah, so America Ferreira was part of, she is an actress, not an American actress. And yeah, she's Latina. And in terms of sense of identity, no, I think that America Ferrera has continually spoken about being a Latina woman in Hollywood, no, and I'm not exactly I can't exactly remember what she said, no, but I guess she has always advocated for more Latina women in Hollywood and more visibility for Latin American people in America, no, so that their sense of, because I think the sense of identity of America Ferrera is really strong, glass, no, she isn't blonde, she isn't white, or she doesn't have white skin the same as white people, but her sense of identity is, and even if in terms of her weight, no, I wouldn't say that she is a stick thin model, but she is extremely beautiful, I think. And if you are a young woman who doesn't exactly conform to the standard, the typical standard of beauty, no, of being stick thin, who are you, no, who am I and what do I want to be? You might want to ask that question about yourself, Klasna. So for America Ferrera, maybe she would answer that question by saying that I am a Latina woman. I am not a white person who has the last name of a white person. My last name is Ferrera, and I am proud of who I am. And how about in social media? How would America Ferrera post a picture of herself on Instagram? No, I do actually follow her on Instagram, but how would she decide on what photo to post? Would she post a picture of herself being pretty during that day? I guess yes, no, but she might what can I be? So what do I want to be, or what type of image do I want to project about myself now whenever I do post online? So you might want to say that, and it whether or not you want to be viewed as someone who is quote unquote sexy. So what whether or not gusto nimo na ipakita ang side sa imo, that is fine, man, class. No, there is no wala may mga objections about that at all. Wala may mo judge sa imo kung mao na imong gusto buhaton, kay that's your right na. So is that what you want, or do you want to just keep a sense of modesty with yourself? So it really depends on what you think is good for you, and it really depends on your sense of identity, no? So that's just an example of the discussion on, sense of identity. Who am I and what do I want to be? So it really starts with that. Second approach to understanding identity development is self-esteem. So self-esteem refers to your self-worth. So is your self-esteem based on your own confidence of yourself, or is it based on the acceptance of other people? Now, generally for female teenagers enjoy high self-esteem when being reinforced by friends. I guess that is where the role of social media comes in, though, that your self-esteem is based on how many people watch your stories. If daghan kitao mutanaw sa imong stories, so murag kakataas imong self-esteem, kakataas imong self-worth tungod sa likes sa mga tao. So nowadays mo naman gud na siya ang basehanan sa self-esteem, no? And this does not just happen to young people, but this is very much relevant to me as well, because I am also on social media. It's relevant to your parents who are on social media, kung wala mag-like silang post. Murag bitaw diha magkabase ang imong self-worth na. So maybe we can try to reassess and evaluate that aspect now. If it's right, is it right to base your self-worth or self-esteem on the likes of others? No, this is a very human tendency and it's totally normal. But should it still be done ba? No. And on the other hand, for men nor for guys, males assert their authority and draw high self-esteem when they are able to reach out to their friends successfully. It's the same for men, no? If their self-worth is based on whether their families approve of their actions, so muna, it's either men would really go for a decision if it contributes to their identity, to their self-esteem. So buhaton na siya sa lalaki if makakontribute siya sa ilang self-esteem. If dili ginabuhaton sa lalaki nga kana nga action. Next is relationship. So another approach to understanding identity development is the relationship that a person has with other people. So their relationships with others can contribute to their sense of identity. For example, peer formation becomes an important part of adolescence. So young people cope with changes in terms of physical. Again, plus peer formation becomes an important part of adolescence. So, being around your friends, for example, is very important, no? Because it can be an important part of your formation of yourself. So, for a moment, plus. Yes. Now, young people cope with changes in life. No? For example, during adolescence or in your teenage years, a lot of changes happen in your body. For instance, it's either you have questions about whether or not you're getting fat. For example, for girls, and I think it's also applicable for boys. No? When there are changes to their body weight, height. And sexually, there are also changes in terms of who you are attracted to. For the LGBT, for example, if there are changes towards the fact that they are becoming attracted to the same sex, then that is also something that is another change, that an important change that is happening to a young person during their teenage years. I mean, social changes that happen during teenage years. So social changes could be how you are act, no, with other people, the goals that you have for yourself during your teenage years, whether you want to be more sporty, whether you want to be popular, no, and then emotional changes as well with your hormones during your teenage years. These are really difficult changes that happen. No, it's whether or not your hormones go up and down, you get angry or happy or sad, no, during certain times. So those are some changes that happen in a young person during adolescence or during teenage years. And young people cope with changes during that time. And these changes are often, sometimes young people cope through their friends, no? And these factors build up pressure and cause confusion. Sometimes you're confused about your body, you're confused about who you're attracted to, you might be confused about whether or not you should aim to be popular, not in school, or you're confused about how you feel sometimes, that why am I feeling this way sometimes? Because that's essentially how you should be feeling because you are a teenager, no? But often it could even lead to identity crisis, no? Because you don't understand yourself sometimes, and that is totally okay. But I think it's important for us to just go through, I think it's important for young people to just experiment and try things out, no? And try to see what works for them and what doesn't. It doesn't mean that you should never try things. I think it's even more important to try things, to try to give it a shot, no? Whether that be being attracted to a certain person, give it a shot, talk to that person, no? Or in terms of your body, so whether or not you have to decide for yourself who do you want to be? Do you want to be healthier? So you try to work out, no? You try to take a diet or try to eat healthier, no? In order to be healthier, is it important for you to be healthy or is it important for you to be thin? Is it really that important for you to be thin? Because I think this standard of beauty in society class is sometimes unhealthy, especially for young people. No, but I think also to a degree, it can also give you a lot of power if you are able to be that beautiful, no, through hard work, through diet, through exercise. Naman siya okay man sad kaayo kung ma-achieve sa isa ka tao ang kanang standard of beauty to a degree, no. Pero dili ta sad na kanang lopsided gamay nga unhealthy na sad imong relationships, imong own body sad. So yeah, those are just some points about identity development. And in that sense, if ever you have become secured in your own identity class, no, hopefully That can then translate to whether or not you still have a need to belong to your whether or not you still have that need to belong among in your friends or in your family. And then that is also where you can also reflect on whether or not you are going to conform to gender norms. No? So with the presence of peer pressure, the teenager must conform his or her behavior with his or her peers, regardless of gender, in order to belong and be accepted. Now, let's look at some gender differences class in social interaction. Let's try to differentiate the actions of boys and girls now in relation to communication, for example. So communication produces definitions of masculinity and femininity. How we talk now as a boy, as a girl, or as a gay person, how we talk, how we communicate produces definitions of masculinity. So a boy would talk like a boy, or a girl would talk like a girl, or a gay person will talk like more like a girl if they want to identify as to be more feminine. Now, communication really produces definitions of masculinity and femininity. In that sense, let's look at some differences between boys and girls in terms of how they communicate now in a masculine or feminine way. So men usually talk on subjects of common interest. Tanang say common in yung duha mon ang ginastorya sa lalaki, pero women, on the other hand, build friendships based on mutual support. So if you can notice nga sa isa ka office, for example, kay ang babae kay or ang leadership style bito sa mga babae, or even sa ang teaching style sa mga babae compared sa mga lalaking na teachers, kay ang mga babae nga teachers usually kay mas kuan sila, mas people pleasing sila. They build friendships with their students, they build friendships with their colleagues. Una ang style sa babae, no? Pero ang lalaki kay kanang they talk more on common interest, more friendly ang approach sa lalaki. Pero kuan dili kaya nga naka-importante sa lalaki nga magkaamigo mo sa ubang tao, no? Compared sa babae, mas people pleasing gamay ang babae. In addition, men tend to talk more than women in public situations, whereas women tend to talk more than men at home. Men are more likely to look away from each other, whereas women are more inclined to face each other and make eye contact when talking. Men tend to jump from topic to topic, but women tend to talk at length about one topic. Men are more likely to listen silently, whereas women make more noises such as mm-hmm and aha. Men are more inclined to debate, whereas women are more likely to express agreement and support. In school, on the other hand, gender differences in school. For boys, teachers believe that boys are good at mathematics and influence them to pursue further education towards computer science or engineering, whereas girls are assumed to be more compassionate and caring for others and are encouraged to go for home caring, dressmaking, and other analytical skills like social work, nursing, or engage in the teaching profession. Boys are more likely to speak up during a class recitation and even if not called upon, whereas girls are more motivated than boys to perform well in school during their elementary years. Boys have the tendency to ignore girls' comments and contributions when working on a project in a small co-ed group, whereas girls may try to downplay their own academic ability in order to make themselves likable by both sexes. And then girls earn slightly higher average grades than boys. Now, in high school, boys would still choose science, technology, and math, whereas girls would still go for the arts and literature. Now, some conclusions in relation to gender and socialization class na. Firstly, I think it would be good to conclude that you should get to know yourself first, no, or we should get to know ourselves first in terms of our identity and whether or not we will decide to conform to society or not. No. If we are secure in our identity, maybe we don't need to try to please other people and we won't have that strong sense to belong in a group because we are assured of ourselves. However, it's also okay to conform to a group man class na depende man na siya. But I think it's really more important to have a strong sense of self first and not rely on the acceptance of other people. Mao man gyud na siya importante yun. Pero usahay, okay naman sad nga naa kay need to belong to others, nga kanang gusto ka nga madawat ka sa uban, okay naman sad gyapon na siya. Also, we can also try to understand other people. For example, if you have a friend nga galibog ka kay, example for guys especially na nakayamigo nga lalaki, galibog ka nga nung gakausab ang behavior usahay, but maybe that is what his way of trying to keep his own self sense of self sad nung basig na ay mga nasila gakaagian usahay. So sabto na lang natong ubang tao kay basig sila po they are also trying to understand or trying to determine their own sense of self as well or ganilang own self esteem. So it's either inyo silang pasagdan or tabangan inyo silang mausab ang ilang panglantaw about silang kagulingon nga mahimo silang more confident. Unya kana ang inyong friendship duha kay importante mayapon nga ipadayon kitungod kay you are there for them, no? It's either a friendship or your family members, no? Inyong magsuon, bakaha, ana, etc. So that's it. Discussion questions, class, no? Should we conform to what society expects of us? Or what if we will not conform and do not behave according to what society expects of us in terms of our self-expression, how we dress, for example? Will we be ostracized if we do that? How bad could being ostracized be? And should our priority be on conforming to our society's norms or should we prioritize being ourselves, staying true to who we are, our truth, and keeping our own peace of mind, not conforming to society's unrealistic standards for beauty because it is exhausting to conform to society's standards of beauty. It's not just exhausting, it's also very expensive. No? Kanang sikag pa beauty, sige, gusto ka magwapa, kakapoy ra niya, kagasto ra, no? Or is it worth the money, no? Or is it worth the money and effort because it will make you who you want to be, no? Okay, ra miyat man sad na. So those are some discussion questions that I will ask you during our synchronous class. So please answer these questions, no, the two questions here. Let's now just proceed shortly to gender in government and law. This section won't be too long. So in government, in terms of women in leadership nor women in government, let's look at the fact that individuals continue to develop their social interactions with a larger group of society. Women today, like men, struggle to gain influence and change the world by complementing men in terms of capability to run the home, run politics, have a career, no, or engage in any professional undertaking. So there is still that challenge nowadays in our society, you know, for women to really contribute. So in today's society, there's an increasing acceptance of women though as leaders. So that's good in Philippine society. There's a growing acceptance already of women leaders in government and in society in general. Now, let's look at one law class now that aims to achieve gender equality in the Philippines. We have RA 7192, an act promoting the role of women in national development. This mandates that all government agencies in the national level must allocate 5% of their budget to gender and development. So maybe you can notice that from the Commission on Audit to the Department of Science and Technology to the Department of Natural Resources, no, in the Philippines and even in the city government, naagi mga projects nowadays on gender and development because that has been a mandate in our government. And sa inyo pong mga gender projects class, pwede po ninyo itap. You can actually tap the government, no, for funding for your gender and development projects for this month and next month. So why not? I encourage you to apply for funding or make a partnership with a government agency because they do have cash, no, but say kanang gahuna-huna na sila sa project na pwede nila buhaton. So pwede ninyo na siya itap nga possibility to approach a government agency for a partnership for your project. Moreover, the Convention on the Elimination of All Forms of Discrimination Against Women, or the CEDAW, which is an international law, imposes obligations on government to adhere to gender equality. And that would be all, class, for the lesson. For any questions, we can discuss it during our synchronous class. Again, there will be an assessment for clear theory, the Yogyakarta principles, and then gender and socialization, gender roles and socialization, and gender and government and law during our synchronous class this week. Thank you and have a good day, class. Bye-bye.